Amen. Now, I want to share with you a word I am believing God to bring very short so that we can do other things which are very important. Amen. How many of you were here last Sunday? When I was talking about the way the mind operates,
it says, "Say again,
why you should own your mind."
Say one case,
so what you want of your mind.
Now we do what James so.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, 2 years ago, I decided to do a very deep study on the body,
the human body.
I really did a thorough study on it. And I realized something. That without your body, your spirit cannot manifest on earth. Cannot do anything here on earth. In fact, without your body, your spirit must leave. In this earth, your body is very important. This is your body. Very important. So God told me something. Keep this body. Make sure the body is strong. Make sure the body is well. Any part of your body is important. Amen. So every part of your body is important to God. Amen. So your body is very, very important. Tell somebody, my body is important. Some of you think this body can be treated anyhow. No. No. Let me tell you this. Even the scent of your body is important.
Hello.
The scent of your body is important. How many of you know that the Holy Ghost has no place to dwell but inside you? Yeah. The Holy Ghost is dwelling in you. You are the temple of the Holy Ghost.
So
this body is very important. You know, and that was because I decided to do that because I realized that some people sometimes think that spirituality means just forget about this body. Even if you don't comb your hair, you look more spiritual. No, but it's not true. God is very interested in your body. For example, if God puts a powerful gift in you, and you don't know how to keep your body sent, your mouth, everything, when you pass people, they fall under the anointing by force. Not because the anointing is falling, but your scent, they don't want it. When you want to preach to somebody and you are talking to the person is in a hurry to go away.
Because
what is coming out, that means that you have used your body to hinder the Holy Ghost from acting.
You
know that the Bible says something. The Bible says something very short. It says, if you destroy this body, God will destroy you.
That is why
suicide is not an option for a Christian.
No
matter the problem. Suicide is not an option for a Christian. No matter what is happening, take care of it. Because if he destroys this body, God will destroy you. Because he needs the body. Amen.
Amen.
So as long as we are on earth, our body is very important. Our brain is very important. Look, without this brain, you can't go to school. 1+1. What? I thought I heard 3. I would have been looking for the one who said 3. 1+1, 2. You know where? Your brain has been trained. Your job, which you do, your brain is trained. There are many things your brain receives them and makes them possible in your life. And so your brain is very important. Now, this is the reason why I'm saying all that I'm saying. Without your brain, there cannot be your mind. Today he has gotten the right word. So if the brain is not there, you can never have the mind. How many of you understand what I'm saying? But how many of you remember that we said that the mind is intangible?
You can't see with
the eye. You can't touch it with your eye. But the brain, you can see. Just as you cannot see the spirit in me, but the spirit is in me, but the body you can see. So you understand now. So when we are talking about the brain, I want to say this emphatically today, that developing your brain is important for your advancement as well. Any work you do, you need to develop it. You see, this man is an architect, a very refined one, and a great man. Amen. And that is because, you see, the other day we went to Bolega, and they were talking about something. And the man was talking, and we were not seeing, me and Pastor, we were not seeing it. They are changing the design of their roof. And the man was saying it, we were not seeing it. Then I said, draw this in quickly and let's see, because if we don't see it, we ignore it. He just did and everybody said, oh, it's nice, it's nice. Pastor said, oh, no, it's nice, it's nice.
The two,
it was in his brain. But we couldn't see. You understand? Now, what has made him powerful as an architect? Get this. Get this. It's not actually his spirit. I know it should shock some of you. Is what he has accumulated in his brain. If it is spirit, I'm telling you, I can do this and become an architect. I'm an architect. And by shaking my head, I can become an architect. It's a shock. So you can shake your head and become a mechanic. No. You can shake your head and become a doctor. No. Your brain is needed. But after your brain has been
filled,
your mind is the one that will control you. That's what we are saying now.
Right.
And that's what we ended up saying last week. That the mind is the coordinating power of the whole being.
Okay,
last Sunday we spoke about the mind of Christ. How to operate in the mind of Christ. On Wednesday, very powerful service, very short word. I don't intend to go into it, but I'll say one thing so that I can connect it. One of the things we concluded was that you can have your two eyes, but they are okay. Where is my doctor? Let's see, man. Where is he today? Should have been sitting close to me. All right. You can have your two eyes very well, clear. But if you are in a total darkened place, whether you like it or not, you will
Hit things.
You'll be hitting things. Because what makes your eye to be able to see, it's not darkness. It's light. So if there is no light in a place, no matter how good your sight is, how good your eyes are, you will kick things. In the same way, there is some light you need for that mind of Christ to see. And if you don't have that light, you will have the mind of Christ, all right, and yet you cannot see some things. Am I communicating to somebody? You see, there are many people who think that when you... there are people who find it difficult to understand that God says we have the mind of Christ. Everyone who is born again, potentially, you have a powerful mind to see things. Powerful. The mind is strong. It is the mind of Christ. Say amen to that.
Amen.
Say, I have the mind of Christ. Come and shout, I have the mind of Christ.
Listen,
it is non-negotiable. As long as you are born again, for we have the mind of Christ. So the mind of Christ is
with
you. It is not a question of whether you have it or not. If you are born again, it is there. But the reason why you are not seeing it, is it light or darkness that is covering it.
You
see, I'm standing here, alright. If this place all of a sudden becomes total darkness, I'll find it difficult to walk here. I may walk and come and step on my brother and say, hey, sorry. Then I'll be, because the eye is good. Everything is alright.
You say, and you know, Bibia,
environment, which is darkness, does not make the eye to see. It is in the same way that most of us have the mind of Christ, or we have the mind of Christ, but we find it difficult to operate because the environment we have created is an environment of darkness. Okay, now let me go to my word, my scriptures. Matthew chapter 6, from the verse 21. To 25. Don't stand. It's okay. Just open to it. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. The light of the body is the eye. If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. Remember, it says thy whole body. Thy whole body. He's not talking about just this flesh, but thy whole body will be full of light.
23.
But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness? No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Amen.
Amen.
Therefore, I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat, what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on. It's not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment. Now, what I'm interested in this last scripture is, take no thought. Now, we all know that thoughts are in our mind. Now, thinking and reasoning is in the mind. It draws information from everywhere. But thoughts are in our mind. In our mind. I didn't say in your brain. In the mind. That's what we saw last week. But it's talking about if thy eyes be single. Great is the light that is in you. Your whole body is in light. But if your eye be evil, then not ehunadio, be evil. Just put the word evil there. That's the word. Evil. I will explain.
Okay.
Because the eye see you, but what is seeing is what makes it evil.
You understand?
Some of us, our eyes love to see some things. I just told you what you surround yourself with can let you see or not see.
Alright.
So now let me talk about this. Now, let me give you this quickly so that I can end this thing in some short time, because I don't want to preach on it long. We will talk more about it. There are three different kinds of eyes everybody has.
Now,
I know when I mention it in from the word of God, you will know. We have the physical eye. These two balls. It's what we call, it is what gives us the physical sight. Sight.
Right.
Or vision. You can see. Sight is not the same as eyes. I told you that eyes is a combination of this and the nerves that go to the brain.
Okay?
That's why people are colorblind. He's seeing all right, but his mind tells me him is red when it is blue. I have so many people in life, only the primary colors is what they know. Yellow, green, blue, And what? Red.
The white.
That's all they know.
And one. And I know.
But that's white and black.
But tum tum.
That's all they know. Now, you know why that is all they know? It's not because some of them, it's not because they are colorblind.
And yes,
they have not educated their brain to differentiate colors that are close to those colors. But people who have trained themselves, you put the colors and they can tell you, this one is purple, this one is that, this one is that, this one is that. They won't say it's blue. You, everything is blue. Everything that is close to blue is blue. They will tell you the difference. They will tell you this is sea blue. This is that blue. This is that blue. This is that blue. They will tell you all the difference. And it's not because their eyes see something different. They have trained their brain to be able to identify them. So what you inform your brain affects your mind to be able to give a correct interpretation of what is going on. If you don't have certain information, no matter what you see, you cannot give a correct interpretation of it. This is why a believer, your mind can be very good and give you right interpretation if you surround it with the spiritual things and the word of God, and you focus it on God's word, you focus it on meditation of God's word. Then your mind becomes powerful and it is able to look at everything and give you the correct interpretation, and so cause you to act in a certain way that is good for you.
And he said, "Oh, you did near what you bet me, I papa. Then she said, 'Oh, man, on Yamia Semino, not ordinary share to be out, oh, Jin, Yamia Semino, a bit me, I'm watching, and Yaman, ye, I'm a name with a pet.'
So we have the physical sight, which is through the eyes and the brain,
and they are also,
so that we see. Amen.
Amen.
But like I explained, you know, all of us can. You see, a doctor can just look at somebody's eye, and his interpretation is that,
doctor,
there is sickness in the blood of this person.
Oh, doctor
is here. But you and me can look and say, hey, akwari neni efu.
Me no bet me a share so
neni kalendi efu pa me papa. You get it? And that is because you can see
to me
and identify it, but your brain is not informed enough to be able to tell you that this thing is sickness and not a normal thing. How many of you understand what I'm talking about? I pray that from today,
Bompa is a friend there.
You will exercise your brain well. When we say memorize the word of God, that's what we're talking about. So that end. Amen. Some of our pastors in our own local, in our own small ways, we say something. Normally, we say something about persuasion. We say, Afo old man, you can't win any argument with him. Even when he's wrong, he will convince you. He can joke with you and you think he's right. It is later he will tell you, don't take what I say serious. Because he will find a word from somewhere and take it out of context and hit you with it. And because the Bible has spoken, you are quiet.
Then
you stand there, and say, oh, you see, I'm just joking. Don't take it. You are right. So in our own circle, we used to say that after old man, you can't win any argument. Because he has kept so much Bible in his head.
But the Bible will be
preaching. It affects the way you reason.
And, you know, I can't.
The way you decide. It helps you to interpret things better. The issues of life. You will interpret them well. Because you see, the light, which is the word of God, has filled you. And your whole body is in the light. How many of you understand what I'm talking about? Listen.
See.
That's how you can be very powerful. I said that's how you can be what? Very what? Very what? So the physical eye is there. But we have also got the spiritual eye. That is the one the Bible talks about in Psalm 119 the verse 18. Open thou my eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of thy way. Every Bible I buy, that's the scripture I write on the first page before I read it. That's my scripture I started with many, many years ago. Open thou my eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of thy way. Is he talking about these two eyes? Is he talking about this?
No.
He's talking about your spiritual eyes. So your spiritual eyes also can inform you, can give you information, can give you sight, so that there are things you can see. But that one is not based on you. It comes from God. That's why the prayer is open down my eyes. It's God that gives you this sight. If God doesn't give you this sight, you cannot have it. Is that okay? If God doesn't give you this one, I can't have it. That's why you pray and say, open down my eyes. Okay? Are you understanding me? Ephesians chapter 1, the verse 17 and 18, the same thing. When Paul was praying for the children, the people of Ephesus, he said that the eyes of your understanding may be what? Enlightened. Who should enlighten it? God enlightened. So as for your spiritual eyes, to receive spiritual sight, it's given by God, by his word, through his Holy Spirit. He gives you to you. And God does it almost every time. So in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, the verse 1 and the verse 9 and 10, as it is written, eye has not seen, neither ear have not heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him. Look at the verse 10. But God has revealed them unto us by his what? Spirit. Now that revelation is the opening of your eye, your spiritual eyes, to see. I was telling my wife this morning that there is a term in the Bible I'm beginning to understand. The word to know it's not just head knowledge. It is your eye seeing it. Your revelation, your relative eye catching it. So they said to know means to you have seen it. Your spiritual eyes have laid hold on it. And that one, God opens your eyes to see. May the Lord open your eyes to see many things. And those things too are the light. So when your eyes sees, when your spiritual eyes sees these things, they are the light that come into your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They just come into your life. And very soon, you are operating in another realm. And some people don't understand why you are operating. They will look at you and say, no, like, we're going to Sikadru. But you are not operating by Sikadru. You are operating by a higher level. May the Lord take you there. May the Lord bring you there. May the Lord prosper you to get to that place. When you are reading the Bible, may the Lord open your spiritual eyes to see.
Amen.
But there is another eye. We call it the eye of the mind. The eye of the mind. The mind has another eye. And that one is in your mind. It's actually your imaginative power.
You know,
so, and listen, now let me say this. Your physical eye sees things that are already there. Bad and good.
Papa and bunny.
Your spiritual eye cannot differentiate. Your physical eye cannot differentiate. Anything it sees, it has seen. You are the one, your mind may only tell you, don't look at it again. But you saw it the first time. Your eye didn't stop from seeing, you saw it. Let me give you a vivid example. And excuse my language. If you see a woman's nakedness, by chance, your eye will say, I won't look.
When you want to catch one,
your eye will catch it first.
When you are be,
but
and so
your mind will tell you later. If your mind is right,
so what
you tell it, turn your eyes away from it.
You will need free so.
If your mind is correct,
so what?
So the first sight It's not a problem. Not for the eye when it's easy to catch. But the second look is determined by what is in your mind. Amen. Oh, we have seen some before. Sometimes when I see some things, I tell my wife, can you talk to that lady to sit well? Because I don't want to tend there again. Some of you even come like that in church. Unfortunately, you come like that in church.
Sorry.
Now, sometimes when you do that, the pastor, we have problem. We have to be running away. Running away. My wife is always on my daughters. Tell them, a lady does not sit like that. A lady does not sit like that. She's always on them. Because you are a powerful creature. You have weapons of mass destruction. Made you like that too.
I mean, the yellow sir.
Not an evil. It's the man who wants to be destroyed who will be destroyed. Amen. In fact, when we are talking about the women, it looks like only the women, but this is the men too. Oh, the men. You must have you. Look, any man should know that there are special areas of your body that attracts women. Have you seen these men? Who, when they are walking, their hands are here like this. How many of you have seen them? Especially the young men. No, that is not an area your hands should be roaming by heart. Why? How huge is it that you can't contain it with your pants? You can't contain it with your pants. You must hold it. You must support it with your hands. Those days we used to be said pants were called supporter. Yours cannot be supported. Your hand must go there and support it. Now. That is just to say that in life, you have the liberty to do some things. But there's some word in the Bible I like. He says, for the sake of thy brother. For the sake of your brother. For example, there's nothing wrong with you dressing the way you like as a man or as a woman. But for the sake of your brother. For the sake of your sister. Is that okay? For the sake. Amen.
Amen.
Should I jump away from that place? All right. Dr. Pat, I'm tempted to say things, but Prof has given me a sign. He's a lecturer, so he says, Amen. But let me finish this thing. So, I was just talking about the eye of the mind. Imagination.
Now,
that one, God does not control it. He has given you it to us as a gift. And we must use our imagination the way we want it. So, your imagination is yours.
Actually,
today's topic is the power of your imagination. The power of your imagination. Your mind can imagine things. And you will get it. You remember that the phrase God said about the people who were building the tower? He said, these people have imagined to do things. Some of the translations use the word imagined. They have imagined to do it. And once they have imagined to do it, nothing can stop them. So I must confuse their why they have imagined.
So
the point is this.
And he said,
your eye, physical eye, can give you physical sight. And that, like I said, You can see many things that are already there. Bad and good. It is your mind that will help you see them. But your mind has also got its eye. And it is the eye of the mind that controls the whole body. That is the one the scripture says. If that eye is single, it's not the eye of the spirit. It's not the eye of, it's the physical eye. It's the eye of the mind. If it is single, your whole body will be filled with life. But if it is evil, then great is the darkness that is in you. How can the eye be filled with light? Or how can the eye be single and or the eye be evil? When you continue the scriptures, you see, no one can serve two masters at the same time. You cannot serve a master, two masters. And he said nobody can serve God and mammon. Now the word mammon, it's a Babylonian, it comes from a Babylonian word, mimas, which means any other thing at all. Any other thing at all.
Now,
well, it has been figuratively been used to refer to money, because money is any other thing at all. So, what the Bible said is that if your eye is on God, great is your light. But if your eye is on any other thing at all, great is the darkness. Because what your physical eyes have seen and your brains have interpreted and what your spiritual eyes have seen or have known from the Spirit of God, when they all come together, it is your the mind of your spirit, the eye of your mind that picks the picture
and found for
to determine what it is, so that you and me can be. So if your mind gives you a small picture and sees a small picture, that's what you are. But you can see big things, and that's where you will be. So the eye of your mind can see big things. Big things. And it is informed by all the other things. The light of the word, when it is powerfully established in you, when your heart is filled with God and the word of God surrounds you, there is no negative thing you catch out there which can give you another mind or another eye in your mind. No. All of it cumulatively will let you have a picture. Alright, let me give you this example. When you take a camera, those days they used to have what they call pinhole cameras. I don't know how many of you remember. And I am with the tour. No, my PMBB now. Kuchia! Kuchia! See, these days the things are so nice. Even these days, they are fine, but they are still the same. It's the same method. But I want to use a pinhole camera. The pinhole camera, will stand well. He says, go back. Or he will move until he can get you well. And when he peeps his eyes and he's looking through the pinhole, and then he's able to catch a real thing, then he will go, Kuchia! And it's finished. Then he will remove the what? What do you call it? The film. And then he will go and watch it. You see, that eye opened once and created a picture in your mind.
I will watch him.
So this whole thing we are talking about, the eye, when your eye is single,
when you are
with the light of the word, it takes a picture. No matter any picture you see, no matter what people tell you, no matter what you read in the papers, no matter what somebody told you, but the cumulative effect of all the eyes, when your mind is well informed in the word and is focused on God, you have one eye. Everything will be worked through that eye. Because you love God, you want to serve God, you love his word, you want to serve him in church, you are filled with him, You are just delighted in God. That is all. And your heart is in it. Every other thing will be seen through that eye. And it will get a picture for you. And normally that picture is supposed to be a good picture for you. That will take you up. That is why, listen, church, listen, let me say this and end. It doesn't matter your background. It doesn't matter what you know and what you don't know. Your mind through the word can give you a picture of yourself. Your imagination can be great. And once you get it and it's in your mind, it will be done. Let me tell you something. Every day when I wake up, when I walk around, I don't know, no matter where I am, whether in Ghana, anywhere in Ghana, abroad, there is one picture in my mind about a church building. I see it clear. I see the environment. I see the place. I see how it is. That picture is always so vivid. And once that is in your mind, that is exactly what you will produce. So if your eye is single, great is the light that will fill your whole body. Your spirit, soul, and body. And so I pray today that you have a single eye. An eye that is resting on God. Eye that loves the Lord.
An
eye that serves the Lord. That gets busy for the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I was listening to a program by Daddy Adiboye. Some call him Daddy G.O. But we call him Daddy Adiboye so that at least we know. But I was listening to him and he made a certain statement and it so much touched me. That was last week. He said, when you are a favorite child of God and you want to be remain a favorite child of God, there are some things you must always look at. Number one, total obedience to God. Number two, total submission to God. Amen.
Amen.
Then he talked about the fact that you must love God and share him with people. Talking about him. You love. No. When you love somebody, you love to talk about him. The least opportunity you have, you want to talk about. If there's any example, it's about the person you love and what you have seen about him. So you want to share about him. Then he said this. You must get the person loves to be busy for God. Busy for God. He's busy for God. He serves in the church not because he wants to be busy for God. He's in the church. He wants opportunity to serve. Because he loves God. And he wants God to keep him as his precious daughter. You become busy for God. There are many people in the church who are not busy for God.
Listen,
don't make yourself just a Sunday church attender. What can I also do to help God? Ask me a question. Do you know that the chair you are sitting on, somebody came and cleaned it? Do you know that some people came and made something well for you to enjoy church? So you ask yourself, what can I also do to contribute to this church? To make it, get busy for God. People who have one eye are focused on God, focused on his word, and focused on the kingdom. They interpret everything through that eye. They don't interpret anything outside God. So if somebody slapped them and everybody says, no, you can go there and reply, they interpret the situation in the light of God whom they love. In the light of his word. And so they choose a path that brings great light into their body. May the Lord fill your body with great light. Not darkness, light. And I told you that if you want to exercise the mind of Christ, All you need is the light around you. I pray that this year, in the year of all sufficiency, may your whole body be full of light, because your eye is single. It's on God. It's on His word. It's on His work. Amen. Your eye is not double. Your eye is single. It doesn't mean you shouldn't work for money.
Work.
But you interpret everything around you in the light of the God you love, the God you are serving, his kingdom, and his work. Amen.
Amen.
That's how the light fills you. May you have a single eye. May I also have a single eye, so that God will bless us. Bow down your heads and pray.